Euron, I'm very excited. I'm standing here with Khairmari and Margo, and I'm with their new book, Make Your Home, 75 Decor and Lifestyle Projects, and we're actually going to use one of them to show you at home how easy it is. Now, the thing about the new year is it's not just about yourself, but you can also redo your home in quick and easy ways. So today we're going to be making a focal point on what you can either use in your bathroom or in the kitchen. It's going to be very attractive, and we make it with a printed tile stamp.
Yes, absolutely.
So Margo, how much time do you need to prepare the space you're going to be working with?
Well, Khairmari, you prepared it for us, so
yes.
How much time?
Well, this takes about half an hour to 45 minutes. So basically, you just start with a piece of chipboard. And very important, and I made this mistake initially, you have to fix your mirror fixings at the back first. Otherwise, if you try to do it afterwards, you're going to break the tiles. So definitely fix them first. And then you just space your tiles and you fix them with the proper tile fixator, if you get an already mixed one that you can get. From your hardware store or your tile supplier, and then you just put your tiles in, and then you grout, normal grout, any color you like. We used white, and then after, it's very important, you have to use a tile primer.
Okay.
And I used two coats of tile primer on this, and you have to cure it overnight, and then you can paint pretty much any kind of tile. This was a gloss tile, I don't know if you can see, but it's actually very matte at the moment, so.
Okay.
It's perfect now to paint on.
And when you talk about paint, because if we're going to use this in the kitchen or in the bathroom, odds are it's going to get some steam or humid. Mm. Is there a special paint you need to use?
Well, the beautiful thing is we're going to seal this. So you can use a water-based paint.
Water-based paint.
Yeah, in the color of your choice, yeah. Like this beautiful blue we are
okay.
using.
Yeah. You can use any PVA, any water-based paint, but it's very important that you use the proper sealer afterwards. And you can find a sealer at your tile supplier again. Just ask for a porcelain or a ceramic tile sealer and you're good to go.
Okay.
Three coats, eh?
Three coats.
Yeah. Now, once you've, I see you applying the paint
yes.
to the stamp, do you put it then directly onto the tile or is that not a good idea?
Oh no, darling, we check this first.
Okay.
So we test it on a piece of newspaper. We use unprinted because then you can see your print quite well.
Okay, ooh, that looks lovely.
How pretty.
That looks
it's
lovely.
It's got this little vintage thing going because it's yes. not solid, solid.
Okay, so you'll always test it first on the newspaper before applying it to your tile.
Just to get the feel of the stamp, because it's quite a big stamp, and you want to see that the consistency of your paint is right, and that you're getting the print that you want.
Okay.
It's actually better to use a thicker paint.
Mm.
And by testing it on the paper first, of course, you get nice gift wrap as well.
Oh, yeah. That's
yeah.
a very clever
that
idea. So you don't
exactly.
waste anything.
No.
And then also, I noticed that if we're going to use this in the kitchen for a splashboard, it is loose. Why do you not do it on the actual kitchen tiles?
Okay, so there's two reasons for that. The first one is if you make a mistake, you've already done it on the wall. Actually, three reasons. The second one is it's much easier to just print like this than to print like this.
Okay.
Right, so to print in this direction. And then third, if you move or if you don't like it anymore, you don't have to chop anything off. You just take it off.
Take it with you.
Yeah. It's a nice student project because they rent and they can take it with.
Yes, and a lot of people that rent, not just the students. That's perfect
it's
for anyone.
It's
Do you want to show us how it will look on the tile?
So this, our stamp is the same size as our tile. It was designed like that. And we're simply going to put it down and put the weight evenly. Try not to move it because then you're going to get a little bit of a blur. But you know, there's no hard and fast rules. You can play a little bit. We do believe in making mistakes and sometimes you get the best results.
Yes.
Then it is a handmade product. So you want it to have that authentic look.
And then you simply lift it from the one side to the other. And voila, isn't it just beautiful?
It is beautiful. So every time you touch down, do you have to reapply the paint?
Yes,
okay.
You do. You could double stamp this. I love this. I'm not going
to
double stamp that.
You don't
mess with perfection.
No.
But if you're not happy, you can always double stamp.